Okay, first we go to the USGS website. I'll include a link in the video description. And I'll show you some earthquakes here, like for example in the Dominican Republic at the bottom. If I go to the end, there's the depth of the earthquakes. And now I'll show you how to actually find them. What we do is we go to Custom in the data feed, then to Advanced Options. After we've chosen a date range, say from 2000 to today. At the time of recording anyway. And then we go to Advanced Options, and we're basically going to draw a square around North Korea with the latitude and longitude. Again, that's in the video info, or you can just watch what I type here. This will basically put a box around the country just to filter out everything else. And we put the depth to zero. Now, the reason is that they conduct nuclear tests underground, or 0 to 5, just in case they bury it really deep, which they probably won't. And as you can see, here are all the nuclear tests that they've conducted. One in 2006, one in 2009, and one in 2013. And as you can see, they're all in the same vicinity, all at a depth of 0 kilometers, which means that they didn't really do a good job of burying it very deep. And you can go there to see which one's which. Now you can also see the magnitudes there, so they've obviously been getting stronger and stronger. You can also see on Google Maps, if you'd like, you can plug in the latitude and the longitude into Google Maps. And I'm doing that now. Yeah, so just copy and paste, press Maps, and it'll take you straight there. Now, they've got, near this site, there are gulags down here, which is basically a prison camp, forced labor. And there's another one up at A, I think. Yep. And I'm going to zoom into the nuclear test area now. There's Nuclear Test Road. I actually came upon this idea how to find the nuclear tests when just browsing North Korea's geography in Google Maps. And I thought that maybe this is the area where they conduct tests, and in fact it is. I'm going to just zoom in on the actual site. Now you probably won't be able to see anything because it's an underground test. It's probably not in this exact area. This is just an approximation. And what this looks like actually is a snow-covered forest. So not very interesting. But anyway, that's how you detect the North Korean nuclear test. And this is a fairly rapid method because the USGS data streams are updated frequently. And yep, it's a forest. And that's it.